In the last video, I told you that I live in a humid place and that's why I had to buy a filament dryer. I have a dehumidifier running in the room, but now I will show you how I'm using my 3D printer to achieve good results. This is a filament that I haven't used for some time. I keep them in the original package with the desiccant back inside. The guys from the store where I bought my 3D printer told me to take out the filament from the printer and keep it inside its bag if I won't use it for more than 3 days. I tried to do that, but it's too humid for some of the filaments and it doesn't make much difference. Some filaments are sold in a Ziploc bag, which is a nice feature. I'm not showing the brand of the filament because I'm not sure which one came with this bag. Every time before turning on the printer, I had to put my filament spool in the dryer. Make sure the end of the filament is coming towards the hole on the lid. In my case, the hole is on the back of the lid. Now I will turn on the dryer and I will set it to 50 degrees and 4 hours because the filament inside is PLA. I have used 3 different brands of PLA filaments so far and I can tell that some of them absorb the moisture of the air faster. After I turn on the dryer, I have to wait several minutes until the sensor detects the correct level of humidity. Keep an eye on the screen to see how the humidity level will suddenly rise. If you want to learn more about this dry box, you can click on the info card in the upper right corner. After some time in the dryer, you may see some moisture on the lid, so you may leave the hole for the filament open and the moisture will evaporate faster. You can even pull the end of the filament through the hole to prepare it for the next step later. While the filament is drying, I will prepare the files that I want to print. Various filaments will require different durations to dry, so keep an eye on the dryer. From my experience, I can start printing as soon as the humidity level is under 25%. The humidity level of the filament is 15%, so I can turn on the printer. I will keep the dryer running. First, I have to pull out the filament from the hole of the dryer. Now I will use the cutters to cut the end of the filament at a 45 degree angle. The dryer is on the left of the printer, so I will pass the filament over the spool stand and then I will insert it into the filament sensor. Click on the second tab from the menu, then select Extrude/Retract and click on Extrude. The printer will start heating the nozzle to 240 degrees. The nozzle heats up very fast, so as soon as the temperature gets above 200 degrees, I will press the lever and I will insert the filament in the feeding hole as far as possible. Once the heating is complete, the printer will extrude a bit of the filament and it will be ready for printing. A small string of plastic will get out of the nozzle. You have to remove it, but use tweezers since it will be very hot. The next thing I typically do is to wipe out the dust on the metal plate and make sure it doesn't have any stains or greasy fingerprints. If the plate isn't clean, the first layer won't stick to it and the print will fail. So make sure to inspect it well. If there are stains over it, you can use some dish soap and warm water to clean it. After that, you have to wait until it is completely dry or use some hand towels to wipe it off. You may do this while you're waiting for the filament to get dry. Now click on the Files tab and select the file that you want to print. Make sure the calibration box is checked and click on Print. Now the printer will heat the nozzle, then go through the bed leveling process and after that will start printing your file. I'm always staying next to the printer until the first layer is done. If the first layer looks good and the filament is dry, there is a big chance the print to be successful. After the first layer is printed, I can go and continue working on my other tasks. I like to open the Creality software and monitor the printer from my PC. Under the Device tab, I can see the print progress. If I click on Details, I will be able to see some more information and also adjust some of the settings if needed. I don't have a camera connected to the printer, but if you have one, you can monitor the printer in real time from this software as well as from the mobile app. When the printer is done, I have to click on OK. Next, I will go to the second tab of the menu again and I will click on Extrude/Retract. This time, I will click on Retract. The printer will hit the nozzle again. This happens very fast. When the temperature of 240 degrees is reached, the printer will extrude a bit of the filament first, then retract it. This will prevent leftover filament from getting stuck in the nozzle. Please don't forget to support me by liking the video and subscribing to my channel. Now you can easily take it out, wind it around the spool and put the spool back into the bag. This is the Christmas decoration I printed. I will spray paint it and I will put it in front of my TV. That's all for today. Have a nice day and see you next time.